by my place after, so I can pay you in full.
No!
I'll head home on my own. After all, I'm only a little sore.
It's cool. We'll go together.
Aw, thanks, bro.
Cut that out.
This way. Think Jesse and Biggs made it back safe?
I guess.
Cool if we check on them? We'll pass by their places anyway.
Sure.
I would wonder how long it takes Cloud, how much time he has to spend with these characters for him to grow any kind of affection for them. Now, I don't think he particularly likes these people, but at least he's willing to tolerate Wedge here for at least a little bit.
Well, this is Big's place. I guess he hasn't made it home yet.
Guess not.
Hope he isn't worst-casing it again. He's got a habit of overthinking things, worrying about all the possible outcomes till his head hurts.
Wouldn't have guessed.
And when he worries, I worry. Yeah. Anyway, let's head on over to Jesse's.
There wasn't any detail given in the original game as to where the members of Avalanche lived. Even Barret and Tifa didn't seem to live anywhere. I guess if they're gonna play the game like this, they kinda have to flesh that out a bit.
This is where Jesse lives. Men are not allowed inside. Lots of pretty girls trying to make it big on stage live here. So don't hang around or they might get the wrong idea. I'm telling you this for your own good, Cloud. People around here love to gossip.
They know about Jesse and Avalanche?
Nah, it's all good. They think she's an actress. Oh, and one more thing, bro. It's all a game to her. Don't fall for it.
You lost me.
Life's a stage and love's the play. Guys aren't allowed, remember?
Well, if he's what he's saying there is true, that does kind of give a little bit of an explanation as to Jesse's rather overt affection towards Cloud. She's just sort of playing around with him.
Hey there, Bigums, Reggie, Smalls. Brought a new friend to meet you. These little guys are on guard duty today.
Okay.
Thanks for seeing me home.
Really sorry about your ass.
It's all good, bro.
It's kind of weird when you call me that.
Hey, don't be scared. Deep down, he's a big softy. It's okay. It's okay. Good job, guys. Great work.
How the hell does somebody like Wedge fall in with a group like Avalanche? I mean, they're kind of an extremist group, and he comes across as a little bit more of a harmless individual. Or at least goofy.
Well, if it isn't Cloud Strife, was wondering when you'd show up. Without further ado, here you are. Thanks for stepping up, Merc. And now, for the cherry on top.
Okay, I get it. Mind letting me breathe?
Depends. Mind coming over tomorrow night? My roommates should all be out for a while.
Are you seriously that desperate? Just let go already.
Only if you promise to come back tomorrow night. Deal?
No promises, but I'll think it over.
Really? You will? I'd make a mean pizza, I'll have you know. Marsh, Louche, Black Millie, Red Shelly? I use only the best ingredients. Sound good?
Never heard of any of that stuff.
Oh, you are so adorable, you know that? You just leave everything to me. It'll be great. Nighty-night. Psych!
Bad idea.
It's kind of screwy somebody who goes and so overtly plays with other people's emotions like that. I mean, I guess it's possible that she has been doing this for quite a while. I mean, Wedge had said that it's all a game to her, so he must have seen her go through this kind of thing with other guys before. Maybe even him, I don't know. It doesn't seem to be affecting Cloud in the way that she probably expected it to, which is probably why she is trying so hard. It's also possible that she figures the only way she can get Cloud to go and do things for her is to flirt with him. Or maybe it really is just a game to her, and she's playing a character when she acts the way she does. Either way, it comes across as kind of a messed up thing to do. Now, it seems as though the fan reaction to this game, to Jesse, seems to be quite positive. People love Jesse in this game. I mean, I guess she's charming in a certain way. But, yeah, I don't know. She seems a little too disingenuous. And her flirting with Cloud seems a little overt. It's the kind of thing I expected of Aerith, not Jesse. And even then, it's a little over the top even for what I expected of Aerith.
Yeah.
You were out for a while.
Just walking.
I ran into Johnny, by the way. Said not to worry, he was getting out of town.
Oh, that guy.
You weren't thinking of leaving Midgar anytime soon, were you?
Well, seems this old friend of mine's in a tight spot. Long time ago, I said I'd be there for her. Made a promise. So,
can't say this is quite what I had in mind when I put that on you way back when.
If you want to talk, I'm listening.
Huh? What's with you all of a sudden?
With me?
Like you're losing that hard edge.
That bad?
Not at all. I like it. Maybe Marlene won't be so scared of you next time. I'm really glad to have you back, Cloud. Really glad. Oh, it's pretty late, huh? I'd like to catch up more, but we should probably both get some sleep, yeah?
Yeah.
Good night, then.
Good night, Tifa.
Thank you.